The U.S. Navy has achieved a significant milestone in its hypersonic weapons program with a successful end-to-end flight test of a conventional hypersonic missile at Cape Canaveral Space Force Station, Florida. The test validated the Navy's cold gas launch methodology, which enables the missile to be ejected to a safe standoff distance from the ship prior to ignition of the first stage booster. Vice Admiral Johnny R. Wolfe Jr., Director Navy's Strategic Systems Programs, SSP, which is the lead designer of the common hypersonic missile, stated, "This technical achievement brings SSP one step closer to fulfilling our role of providing a safe and reliable hypersonic capability to our Navy. The test is part of a broader development program in partnership with the Army's Rapid Capabilities and Critical Technologies Office. Follows two successful end-to-end flight tests conducted in 2024. Secretary of the U.S. Navy John Phelan stated, "The speed, range, and survivability of hypersonic weapons are key to integrated deterrence for America. The conventional prompt strike CPS system will be first deployed aboard the USS Zumwalt." In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how the Zumwalt class is getting closer to being armed with hypersonic missile. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted and fastest VPN brand that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte. NordVPN provides a 256-bit encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy and also enables you to access contents that are blocked based on geolocation. Its threat protection system helps you avoid phishing, scams, and malware. NordVPN application is available for all the major platforms as well as browsers. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive saving by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. Conventional prompt strike CPS is a conventional intermediate range boost glide hypersonic weapon system. The CPS all-up round missile includes a two-stage solid rocket motor booster and a common hypersonic glide body CHGB containing a kinetic energy projectile warhead. The U.S. Department of Defense has been developing the CHGB so that it will serve as the base of its offensive hypersonic missile. CHGB will be used by the different services of the U.S. military, Army and Navy. U.S. Navy was put in charge of developing the CHGB. The design of the common hypersonic glide body is based on the previously developed alternate reentry system, which was tested in the early 2000s as part of the Army's Advanced Hypersonic Weapon Program. The alternate reentry system was itself based on the Sandia Winged Energetic Reentry Vehicle Experiment prototype, developed by Sandia National Laboratories in the 1980s. CHGB's dimensions are common across the Navy and Army and have been developed keeping in mind many aspects. In the CPS system, the glider will be launched to extremely high altitudes using a ballistic missile, then separate from the carrier missile, and will skim back to the Earth towards its intended target, attaining hypersonic speed. Hypersonic speed means the object exceeds Mach 5, which is 5 times the speed of sound. This is about 1,715 meters per second, or 3,836 miles per hour, or 6,174 kilometers per hour. The glider will also be able to maneuver in flight unlike traditional ballistic missiles and is much faster than a typical cruise missile. The combination of high speed and the ability to take an unpredictable path will make the missile a lethal weapon. There is no dependable way to intercept this kind of weapon at present. Each service of the U.S. military will use the CHGB as the base while developing individual weapon systems, such as launchers capable of firing weapons from land or sea. The CPS missile is being seen as providing an alternative to nuclear weapons for strategic retaliatory strikes. The Zumwalt class destroyers have 80 Mark 57 cells protected by the Peripheral Vertical Launch System, PVLS, as well as two 155mm guns. Each Mark 57 cell can carry a single SM-2 or SM-6 long-range surface-to-air missile, ASROC anti-submarine rocket torpedo, or up to 4 Evolved Sea Sparrow short-range surface-to-air missiles. Importantly, they can also carry Tomahawks. The two 155mm advanced gun systems were supposed to be capable of engaging targets with precision-guided shells at ranges of up to 60 miles or 95 kilometers. The Long-Range Land Attack Projectile, or LRLAP, the precision-guided shell that would arm the ship's guns, saw cost escalation from $50,000 a round to $800,000. The U.S. Navy, for this reason, canceled LRLAP. The U.S. Navy decided to rearm the class and shift the focus of Zumwalt from close to shore to blue water engagement with the installation of hypersonic weapons. USS Zumwalt, which arrived at the Huntington Ingalls Industries' Pascagoula shipyard in August 2023, is the first of the class that went for extensive modifications. The modernization effort falls under a comprehensive contract awarded to Lockheed Martin Corporation with a potential value of up to $2 billion to integrate the hypersonic missile systems into the Zumwalt class destroyers as part of a fleet-wide capability enhancement program. USS Zumwalt completed undocking in December 2024. As per reports, the U.S. Navy has determined that the hull can accommodate 487-inch missile tubes. Each of these tubes would be able to house 3 CPS missiles. That means Zumwalt will be armed with a total of 12 of these missiles. The success of this test is a pivotal moment for the U.S. military. U.S. has been lagging behind Russia and China in hypersonic weapon arena. Zumwalt's eventual return to the fleet with hypersonic missile capability would signal a big step for the U.S. military, and specifically the Zumwalt class, which has been mired in controversy. By equipping the Zumwalt class with CPS missile, the U.S. Navy aims to enhance the utility of a $7.5 billion warship that, despite being a testbed for numerous innovations, has often been criticized as an expensive misstep. The second Zumwalt class ship, USS Michael Mansour, DDG 1001, and the third USS Lyndon B. Johnson, DDG 1002, will also have this upgrade, and U.S. Navy is looking to have all three ready to go by fiscal year 2028. Despite initial program challenges, the three Zumwalt class destroyers remain the most technologically advanced surface combatants in the U.S. Navy. The class incorporates a range of next-generation systems, including integrated electric propulsion, a low-observable angular hull design to minimize radar cross-section, a wave-piercing tumble-home hull form, advanced automation for fire suppression and damage control, and a composite deck house that encloses and reduces the signatures of radar and sensor systems. Each ship generates up to 78 megawatts of electrical power, providing the capacity to support power-intensive systems such as next-generation radar arrays and directed energy weapons. The integration of the conventional prompt strike CPS missile would provide the Zumwalt class with long-range hypersonic strike capability, positioning these vessels as among the most formidable and survivable surface combatants in the Navy's arsenal.